James Super Chicken Johnson, born and raised in Clarksdale, Mississippi. This is my chicken on a stick. So when they talk about skewering me, I say, hey, hold up, I already got it. I'm from Mississippi, down at the crossroads, and the part of Mississippi we live in is near three state lines. That's Mississippi, Tennessee, and Arkansas. I put them all three together and I call it Sippy Seekinsaw. Kind of jumping in the gear of E. Around the areas in the country there, farm to farm, and when I was a little boy back in 1957, my grandpa was having a front porch party. And what they called each other brothers back then, and Bro Reed showed up at the party. And I kind of liked the man's style and liked his playing because we had to listen from off a distance. But Mr. Jimmy Reed was playing, and right today he's one of my mentors, you know. I remember the names when I was hearing those names when I was a kid. When I grew up, I heard the names again. I said, hey, I remember that old man. He used to come play with my grandpa, you know. So I kind of took after him. And about one of the, he's my number one mentor.
Going back down to the Delta. Hi.
being poor, you know, we was like recycling before recycling was invented. Because every time we threw something away, we took a second look at it, we went back and got it, and we done something with it. So I make my own guitars now out of found objects, like ceiling fans, gas cans, and you name it. I take it and make a guitar out of it. And it comes from being poor. Chikan made a guitar of a gas can, we call it a Chikan talk. I made one from a ceiling fan, and it's round like a banjo with a guitar neck on it, so we call it a gigio. I made some from cigar boxes, and we call them cigar guitars. And I made one from a toilet seat, and I ain't gonna tell you what we call that.
This was a Mac computer, the power housing for a Mac computer. This thing burned out, ain't no more good, but I got this big piece of equipment here. It still look good, it just don't work. And from where I come from, it's gonna do something. So I tore into the thing and I found this beautiful breadboard on the inside of it. So I tore that out and I said, I gotta do something with this, you know. So I took it and I made me a guitar out of it. I put a Gibson neck on it, so I call it my Gibson Macintosh.
Sell them so people can have one-of-a-kind artwork, and I try to sell them for a price so I can keep them, don't have to sell them. They don't care how much I charge for them, they take them anyway. And I don't refuse it. I'll go make another one.